Now at 10, he killed his wife and kids in the 80s. Tonight, a Milwaukee man is back in custody.
I knew this was going to happen sooner or later. He's smart. He knows what he's doing.
The reason he was out and the new crime he's accused of committing. Keith Kalota is back in a mental health facility tonight.
The same place he spent 17 years after killing his wife and children. And new at 10, Brendan Conway talks with the victim's family. They say he never should have been released.
He knew exactly what he was doing. I mean, come on, he killed three people.
Al Ulick says he's been waiting for this day to finally come. The day when the man who brutally killed three members of his family would be back in custody.
He killed my sister and her two-year-old and her four-year-old with a knife, you know, stabbed them over 22 times each. Imagine that. So he knows what he's doing.
Keith Kalota went on the killing rampage in 1987. He told police God told him to kill his family. A jury found him not guilty by reason of mental disease, and he was sent to the Mental Health Institute in Mendota. Kalota spent 17 years there, and then in 2004, among numerous protests, he was released to live in Milwaukee. For 6 years, Kalota lived the life of a free man, but now he is back at Mendota.
It all comes back to, you know, him again using a knife, not a gun, not strangling the person or trying to do that. Went back to the knife thing again.
According to court records, Kalota had a girlfriend who he slapped, pulled her hair, and threatened with a knife. The Department of Human Services, who oversees Kalota, says he lied to his case manager for nearly 2 years, and between that and the allegations of violence, they took him back into custody. Ulick says
What's
he always believed Kalota
well,
fooled people to avoid prison.
I'm hoping this is a good thing now. Maybe now they're going to realize, okay, this guy knows what he's doing. You know, maybe they're going to put him away.
Citing confidentiality, the Department of Health Services would not comment on this case today. The district attorney's office says they will handle the hearing next month on Kalota's release. As for the allegations that he abused his girlfriend, pulled a knife, the district attorney's office says they could prosecute that case, Kathy, but at this point they haven't received any information on it.
All right, thanks, Brendan.